Greetings guys, and welcome to another episode about regular expression. Today I'm going to explain new line characters, exclusions and letters. So let's say that we would like to select all of letters present in our string. How to do so? Do this double angle brackets thing, and now two columns and in the middle letter. If we run this code, we are going to get all of present letters. And let's say that we would like to select only lower letters. In this way we can do it. And with upper letters, yes, of course. And how we could use this kind of thing like any other? Let's say we would like the only letters, standalone letters. That means letters in between white spaces. You see, we have only one letter I and one letter E. And now I'm going to show you other thing. Let's say that we would like to select those strings that contains from A to D. And multiple letters. If we run this code, we are going to get all of these strings. But let's say that in one match we want to select those strings that contains letters from A to D, but also letters from S to U. How we are going to do something like that? We are going to wrap this string into these brackets, and then we are going to provide this vertical line. This vertical line means or, and another angle brackets, and in between S to U multiple elements. And if we run this code now, you see we have our matches. But let's say that we would like to exclude certain letters from our matches. We can do it in a simpler way. Let's say that we are going to select entire alphabet, but instead of this kind of expression, we are going to put this hat sign inside of these brackets. What this hat sign means, means exclude all of these elements. So exclude all of letters from S to U. And if we run this code, you see we have totally different result. So you can go in a simple way without this or part, and you could just say exclude all of numbers. If we run this code, you see there is no number to be found. And we could do that in a different way. What if we provide this capital letter D? Let's see. You are going to receive the exact same result. So this small letter D with this slash and D means numbers, and capital D means no numbers. And what if you would like to operate with new line? New line you are going to select in this way. So backslash and D is going to be key for new line, but this first backslash is going to be escape character for this one. So you are going to write this expression in this way. So double backslash and N. And let's say that we would like to select last word from all of these sentences. How to do that? In front of this new line, we are going to ask for all of words, so from A to Z, and then this dot, but dot have to be provided in this way, because dot actually means any character, and if we like actual dot to deal with, we would have to provide these two backslashes in front. So now we are going to ask for all letters plus a dot. And is there anything else? Yes, there is one exclamation mark. And we have to select a multiple of these symbols. And if we run this code right now, you see, we have almost everything. The only thing that we have to find now are numbers. So if we run this code now, You see, we have almost everything. There is only this RU word missing because we are not asked for capital letters. And now we are going to correct that. And if we run this code right now, you see, we have everything. So this would be all for this episode. And tomorrow we are going to continue with our adventure into regular expression. So if you like this content, please subscribe and see ya.